Senior Director General, Sri Dr. R.K. Bhaskar, will present on innovative practice for 24/7 water supply. It is experienced from the Malkapur Water Supply Project, Maharashtra.
Historical नगर पंचायत अप्रैल 2008
Thank you.
Amazon, we have approximately 32,000 population in Malgaon, but we have designed 24/7 pure water supply scheme for up to 97,000 people. This 24/7 pure water supply is also being given to commercial organizations like hospitals and hotels, and it's being given by municipality. In this project, we have used high density polythene pipe. This pipe ideally suited to pressure pipe system with an expected life cycle of 100 years. It outperforms most traditional pipe materials. This pipe is being supplied in 100 meter long wires, which significantly reduce the number of joints and speed up the installation. Electrofusion technique of fitting on joints has been practiced in the all six different water zones in Malgaon.
ये पाइप जो मलकापुर ने इस्तेमाल किया है वो 75 mm, 90 mm, 110 mm एंड 140 mm का पाइप इस्तेमाल किया है। ज्यादातर 75 mm का पाइप जो रहता है वो कॉइल में 100 मीटर कॉइल में आता है। ये जो ज्वाइंट लगते हैं वो ज्वाइंट पर 100 मीटर पे लगता है।
In giving connection to consumer, we are using electrofusion technique to make joints perfectly fit. And this brass will evacuate the water and a single length pipe don't allow any leakage of water. With Infiltron meter, EMR test meters installed, reading can be done remotely by driving through streets using handheld devices and radio frequency when this meter reading is required. It is durable, resistant to corrosion, easy to install and easy to maintain.
That for successful 24/7 water supply system, it has to be 100% metered water supply system, very good state-of-the-art technologies to be used, which are the best in the world and all. The government of Maharashtra agreed for the EMR type of meter, which are hardly used anywhere in India.
24/7 water supply system is being maintained with ultra-modern technique. Water treatment plant is being opened just by sending SMS from anywhere. The water treatment plant checks all its functions and it starts automatically in the same manner as it closes.
हमने पूरा सिस्टम का सर्वे किया, होमटाउन सर्वे किया, लोगों का जो रियलिस्टिक डिमांड है, जो डिमांड था कि हमने वाटर जब सॉफ्टवेयर में वो पूरा डिजाइन करके 24/7 का पहला जो जो टप्पा है वो पार कर दिया। तो टप्पा पार करने के बाद ये इतना आसान नहीं था। क्या था, लोगों को मीटर लगा के पानी देने का कॉन्सेप्ट लोगों की सोच में या दिमाग में नहीं था। इसके वजह से थोड़ा स्ट्रगल हो गया। हम लोगों में गए, लोगों में जाकर उनको समझा दिया कि वह सिस्टम कितना फायदेमंद है। और उसको लोगों में जाकर हमने तो लोगों का एक थोड़ा सा एक सोचने का ऐसा तरीका रहता है कि मीटर मिटाने के बाद उसका बिल बढ़ जाएगा, लेकिन हम लोगों में जाकर उसको समझा दिया कि तुम्हारा बिल जो है अपने जो स्कीम चलाने का है वो प्रॉफिट में तो चलाने का नहीं, लेकिन बैलेंसिंग में चलाने का है। बैलेंसिंग में चलाने के लिए हमको जितना खर्चा आता है वो खर्चों के अनुसार हम उसका अपना टेरिफ लगाए। तो सन 2009 में हम पूरा सिस्टम 24/7 का वो सेटल कर दिए।
I'm living here as a tenant and shift here just because 24/7 water supply. Here we have no problem.
मलकापुर का टोपोग्राफी थोड़ा सा अलग है, कई तरह उतार है, कई तरह चढ़ाव है। उसके पानी का जो संतुलन होना चाहिए वो जोन के अनुसार होना चाहिए, लेकिन एक टंकी से एक जोन छोड़ा कवर होके उनको उसको जो प्रेशर जो लगता है उसके प्रेशर के अनुसार पानी आने के लिए वो जोन ऐसा डिजाइन किया। This is where we work with all the people that the metered water supply you are going to pay for whatever you are consuming. And once the system is started working, it is found that those who year bill from 60 rupees even to 30 rupees. And those who were using more has to pay more. So that's how a social equity is also established. And now it is not we that tell that the bitter water supply scheme is essential everywhere, but the people of Malkapur themselves tell the meter water supply system is required, it is pro-poor, and it emanates to the thing that it reduces the consumption of water even for the richer, because then they start reducing their water requirements as well, and then they start reducing their bill. This is how the story has happened in terms of bills as such.
We have faced a lot of hardship for water. Now we understand the value of water as we are getting 24/7 water supply. 24/7 water supply gives us respect. Sometimes we had to go to fill our water to a long distance and it was all cry for water. We could not do anything. Now everything is all right.
ऐसा अट्रैक्शन था मीटर लगा के जो पेट्रोल और डीजल है जैसा पानी पीतेंगे बहुत सारा प्योरीफाई जाएगा, इसके वजह से लोगों को मीटर और जो मिटाए वो काटने के थोड़ा सा उसे कोई कई लोग कर रहे थे, लोगों का अपना अंतरात्मा से बात करे तो लोगों को समझ जाता है क्या अपने लिए काम कर रहा है, और उसका फल मिलने से थोड़ा सा हमको अच्छा लगता है कि हम समाज के हित में काम कर रहे हैं।
You know, water is alive, and our life was totally engaged in collection of water. Now things have changed. We get 24/7 water supply, and we have plenty of time. Now we attend programs of Mahila Mandal and self-help groups. With 24/7 water, our life have changed. We don't misuse water. We all have water, more consumption of water earns more bills, so we use water just to fulfill our need. 24/7 water supply scheme has given us liberty and free time. Now we do go in village function and another program. Scheme could not be achieved without the full cooperation of Malkapur citizens. Actually, 10% of the total budget of 24/7 water supply had to be deposited by the people of Malkapur.
Scheme का pattern है ऐसा, 90% तो by government से आता है और 10% तो popular contribution. Popular lesson contribution का मतलब ऐसा है, लोगों का तो उसमें हिस्सा रहना चाहिए, लोगों को लगना चाहिए कि अपनी स्कीम है. तो लोगों भी आ गया सके, इसलिए 10% पॉपुलेशन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन का गवर्नमेंट ने नॉर्थ सरकार उसके हिसाब से अभी तक 1 करोड़ और 20 लाख रुपए गवर्नमेंट।
दिस चैलेंज वॉज अचीव्ड विद ग्रेट एफर्ट ऑफ द पीपल ऑफ मलकापुर। अकॉर्डिंग टू द नॉर्म्स ऑफ गवर्नमेंट, पीपल ऑफ मलकापुर थ्रू नगर पंचायत ऑलरेडी हैव डिपॉजिटेड रुपीज 1 करोड़ 20 लाख। Now the people of Malkapur are free from worrying regarding tightness of water in supply. Uncontaminated pressurized water supply 24/7 hours a day, 7 days a week have been provided. The distribution network has been designed using WaterGen software. This software models the system according to the given pattern of usage of water at different times of the day.
WaterGen software में हम पानी का जो demand है लोगों के जो survey करते हैं, लोगों का जो realistic demand उसको model में डाल के वर्क करते कितने कौन से जगह कितना प्रेशर आ सकता है और ईपीएस में हर घंटे में कौन सा प्रेशर कौन से जोन में कितना रहेगा वो पूरा डिजाइन कर सकते हैं। वो वाटर जेन सॉफ्टवेयर में क्या है, तुम्हारा कम से कम कीमत में और ज्यादा से ज्यादा नफे में कैसा डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन आप डालते हो उसका स्टडी एक अवेयरनेस का शुरू हो जाता है उसमें.
इट इज वेरी इसेंशियल टू कंट्रोल वाटर लेवल्स ऑफ ऑल एलिवेटेड सर्विस रिजर्वॉयर्स एंड दिस इज द वन वेयर वी हैव डन इट सो फार विद मलकापुर नगर पंचायत. The ESR has got the two sensors. One is at the full sump level, that is at 100%, and second one is at 40%. As the water level reaches to full sump level, that is 100%, this PLC-based system, it senses the water level and it closes the wall, which is coming in inside the service reservoir. So water supply will be stopped. And as the water is consumed by the users, and when the water level falls below 40%, again this PLC panel, it senses the level and it opens the valve. So again the water will be filled to 100%. So there won't be any wastage of water, not a single drop will be wasted, and all consumers will get water at the appropriate pressure levels. Because this panel sees that the water is always full in the reservoir. So this is the basic use of this automatic ESR filling system.
The work order was given on 7th December and the actual work began on the 8th March 2008. In 2009, the project took off and currently has 4,200 connections.
दो चार बरस में हमने देखा है कि पानी प्रतिप्रवाह सेवन आने से इतना बढ़ रहा है मलकापुर. तो एक चार पांच बरस में हमको एक पैरेलल सिस्टम पे सोच न पड़ेगा ऐसा ही लगता है.
Malkapur have been relieved of the problem of irregular and unpredictable water supply. A study undertaken by the Krishna Medical College Karar reported that the 100% samples are potable and free from contamination.
So of course, we have scientific parameters to decide to see the factor, to see the purity. The Nagar Panchayat has come out with very good results. So what clean water can do, not only prevent disease, but also give you better health. People have become healthier.
Apart from the third party's guarantee of pure water, here in Water Purification Center, every week water is being tested and every month the report of quality of 24/7 supply water is being sent to the head office of Maharashtra Jeevan Pradhikaran, Mumbai.
जो raw water आता है, उसकी quality यहाँ जांच करते हैं और उसके हिसाब से और प्योर वाटर के लिए दो साइड एडजस्ट करके चार के जरिए हम दो साइड एडजस्ट करके हम लोगों को प्योर वाटर जो डायरेक्ट जो रिवर से आता है वो ये रॉ वाटर है और उसके बाद ये सेटल वाटर है और जब हम दो एडजस्ट करते हैं उसके बाद जो प्योरिफाइड वाटर जो है वो डायरेक्ट के लिए जो देते हैं वो ये प्योर वाटर.
A survey conducted by Anganwadi Sevika indicated that the waterborne diseases in children have been reduced remarkably to near zero level. The wastage of water is remarkably reduced because of periscopic tariff structure. The number of hours pumping water has been reduced from 90 to 20 hours to 13 to 14 hours per day. No walls are required to be operated in the distribution network. The consumer opens the tap and gets the water any time of the day and the night. Thus, 24 wall men and their discontent is a part of history. As the pumping of water through the water tank on terraces is not required, water reaches up to the fourth floor with full force, use of electricity is reduced. The energy saved is equivalent to reduction in 450 tons of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. As 11 bore wells with the power pumps of MC and many small pumps have been installed for lifting water from ground to terrace, resulting huge reduction in electricity consumption. 24/7 water supply system of Malkapur has reduced the cost of operation. This has eliminated the requirement of the two pumps operator. The project has not only reduced water leakages, but is also ensuring 24/7 water to every home, with users paying monthly bills as per their usage. Around 70% of the customers, mainly domestic users, are paying water bills
less than rupees 70.
ये पानी महंगा नहीं है, इससे इसके जो रेट है वो सामान्य जो लोग है उनको अलग है, जो होटल के लोग है उनको अलग है, इसलिए हमें ये महंगा नहीं लग रहा है, सबको इससे बहुत फायदा हो रहा है। पानी तो जीवन है, खरीदा ही नहीं, अगर ठीक तरह से यूज करे तो ये अगर हमें भी इसका फायदा हमें भी और हमारे आगे आने वाली पीढ़ी को भी इसका फायदा मिले। बहुत अच्छा लगता है छोटे छोटे यहाँ पे पानी खेती बाड़ी को भी उसका फायदा होता है, किसी को इतना नहीं पता कि अभी पानी आने वाला है, ऐसा कुछ मतलब 24 घंटे उसका यूज कर सकते।
The streamlining of the entire water distribution system has fetched an additional income for the government. Earlier, water tax collection was around 17 lakhs and the expenditure was around 48 lakhs. Under this 24/7 water supply system, water tax collection has increased up to 60 lakhs while the spending is around 50 lakhs. It is almost a win-win situation. The water supply through HDPE pipes has restricted leakage to 5% from 30%. This automatic meter reading system provides accurate reading and has restricted case if tampering. Merits of the 24/7 water supply system: demand-based water supply, consumption only when necessary, billing on actual consumption, round-the-check availability of water, no storage required, hence no wastage. Consumer does not require electric motors for lifting water and thereby saving in electricity bills. Due to continuous positive pressure along the pipelines, there are no chances if entering any polluted water in the system. Water audit is easy. Consumer satisfaction is guaranteed. Like the pipelines was planned and zone-wise execution was completed. A special drive was undertaken to convince people either to fix proper stop cocks to the overhead tanks or employ bypass there, as the pressure is adequate to bring water directly to the tap, even at the fourth floor. Look at these water storage tanks. Now it has no use in Balkapur and even in schools. It becomes a thing to cover space. Water is life and being supplied round the clock in Balkapur, and it has resulted into celebrations and festivals. Success story of 24/7 pure water supply system of Malkapur has inspired many gram panchayats and talukas of this area. Kapila Panchayat has come up with a 24/7 water supply project on the line of Malkapur. Jack well is already under construction. Here we see another jack well under construction for the 24/7 water supply for the Talukla Kara. Undoubtedly, Malkapur has become role model for each and every citizen who knew its success. The Sri-run Maharashtra Jeevan Pradhikaran 24/7 pure water supply project in Balkapur town has been bestowed with the Prime Minister's Excellence Award in Public Administration 2009-2010. With great hope, entire nation is looking towards successful 24/7 model of water supply of Malkapur. Modern technology and great endeavor of government and the people to achieve this success. We say, long live Malkapur and celebrate life.
So this is about Malkapur. Most of the things must be known to you. Is it, or is there some new concept you understood from this film? Now let me recapitulate one by one. In the beginning I had told you that each and every frame is educative in the nature and we learn from each and everything. What did I learn? I must tell you. This is map of Malkapur. On left side you can see there is small station, Malkapur train station, and on the right side you can see the river is flowing from which the sump well was. Now Malkapur Nagar Panchayat, what is Nagar Panchayat? You don't have a concept of Nagar Panchayat here. Nagar Panchayat is actually a notified area authority or notified area council, which has a population anywhere between 25,000 to 1 lakh. This Malkapur was having a population of 90,000. So this water supply scheme was designed for 90,000 persons. And as you saw in the first frame, there was resistance to meters. People thought that once the meters are installed, like meters of electricity, meters of petrol pumps, meters of other places, they will be overcharging. And valuable time was lost in collection of water. Water collection, especially in those areas where there is scarcity of water, in some areas of Gujarat, some areas of Rajasthan, some areas of Maharashtra nowadays, and mostly in some of the southern states where there is no 24/7 water supply scheme, is a big social mobilization. Ladies especially go in a queue, remain in a queue for quite some time, there is gossip, there is social gathering, all kinds of interactions take place, and generally interactions are not of very, very good quality. So they end up in some fighting, some things or the other, and the most important of all, their valuable time is lost in just getting one can of water. Generally you can see, anybody who travels to South India can easily see some of the areas where there is water scarcity, the people having this plastic kind of jerry cans or plastic kind of vessels, what we called ghat or ghada in Hindi, is the same thing, they make of plastic and carry on two or three on their shoulders. This is very, very laborious work for the women folk, because they are responsible for carrying the water in those areas. I never saw any gentleman standing in queue for water collection, and most importantly, most valuable time is lost, apart from social problems. And there is tendency of storage. Once you know that thing is not available, you never know whether next pot will be available or not, so keep as many as possible, keep on storing. If you have one storage, then add another storage. This is common tendency even in the metropolis. There are some areas even in metro, like Delhi, there is a special area called Dwarka. In Dwarka, if anybody has visited those areas, there is no guaranteed water supply scheme. Whenever water is delivered, it is not of very good quality. So people have constructed inside their house one or two big tanks having 500 to 700 liter capacity. It occupies valuable space. It has to be maintained. And then, since you are not sure of the next supply, you keep on adding to your stored water supply. So how this change was brought about? The thing which strikes me first during this viewing of this film is ownership. You saw the pride with which these people were talking, and they were not very senior officers, they were not very, very high ranking officer. One of them was of level of mechanic, lab assistant, who was testing water. Another one who carried us through this film was a section engineer here, who would be of maybe assistant engineer's rank also. And the person who told up in the beginning was executive officer of this Nagar Panchayat, maybe of level of any of employees working here. Not a very, very highly paid employees, but you saw highly motivated employees. They owned the project, they told about the project, and how they told about the project, with a sense of achievement and sense of pride, and what were the problem and how they have been able to solve those problems. So first thing was resolution to change, that this thing has to go and we have to change. Then came the cooperation of inhabitants. You saw that the scheme envisages a grant of 90% and 10% is popular contribution. Popular contribution is the contribution from people who will be benefited from this scheme, and that was collected by Nagar Panchayat, and that was passed on in the project cost. Total project cost of 12 rupees, 10% comes to 1.2 crores, total project cost will be about 12 crore rupees. And it was started in 2009, and this film was made in 2011 or so. Now, how this project actually happened? You saw the intake wells in Koyna River, and in this river flows through Satara district, in which this village panchayat is situated. There were separate tanks for six zones, because you saw the hilly terrain. There were special differences at different places, so they had to construct six tanks for optimum pressure, so that they can supply water to all the required areas. Then there was a talk of HDP pipe. All of the engineers must be knowing HDP pipe. Those who don't know, I can tell you. High density polyethylene pipes. These pipes are supposed to be very long lasting. Since it is plastic material, it does not corrode easily, unlike our GI pipes and MS pipes. GI is galvanized iron, MS is mild steel pipes. Cold. This is Perennial River. other than that it can't be source of water. They claim that life of HDPE pipe is 100 years. It is, I don't know whether it is 100 years or not, but at least I can see it's very long life. That is very easily concluded, that is very, very long life. And since they have to reach water at that 224/7, they are pressurizing the system. So pipe must be of that quality which can withstand that pressure. They are pumping the water, so unless it can withstand the water, the pressure, the material, pipe material must be of very good quality. They used HDPE pipes of 75 mm to 115 mm dia. Then there was use of electrofusion technology. Is anybody aware of electrofusion technology? No, let me tell you a bit about it. Electrofusion technology is basically heating and joining. Since this pipe is made of plastic material, then two ends, there is picture also. Let me show you a picture. I will show you a picture later on. First, let me tell you about the technology. Now, these are pictures also. In fact, there is video. You have done it very good. But others who have not done it, it will be very useful for them. How two plastic pipes are joined. The electrofusion is a method of joining HDPE and other plastic pipes using special fittings that have built-in electric heating element, which are used to make join and weld the pipe together. These pipes are cleaned first, then they're inserted into the electrofusion machine with a temporary clamp, and a voltage is applied for a fixed time depending on the fittings. That generally they are using 40 volts. Voltage may also vary according to dia of pipe and material of pipe. And the built-in heater coil heats, melts the some of the material, it softens it, and then when it is left to cool, it again joins it. It gives a seamless joint, so less pressure, and it becomes very, very smooth. Other than that, we generally use a oak ring. The ring is fitted on one side of pipe, on other side of pipe, ring is tightened, and that is not a very good element. It very easily breaks along, and there is leakage also. This, and there is automatic ESR. The elevated service reservoir filling system. You saw in the movie that he told about when there are two sensors. Once tank is filled 100%, then there is an alert. Then when tank is 40%, then there is an alert. And water pumping starts automatically when their tank level reaches 40%. Now, he also told that there are 4,200 connections already given at the cost of 4,000 to 5,000 rupees per connection, and the portability of this water supply was checked by Krishna Medical College, the person you saw. There was quality check from raw water analysis and tap water analysis both. Lab assistant told it 3 times. He is checking water of raw water, then he is checking water before it goes to reservoir, then when water comes out for drinking purposes, then it is checked again. Then there is talk of telescopic traffic. Telescopic traffic is a very good thing unless you consume more water and you pay less. The only sector where telescopic traffic is not available is electricity sector. In electricity sector, if you find your have a look of your bills, then you find if you consume more, you pay more.
Income tax slab
is very difficult to say. You know, there's philosophy of the government that if you're rich person, you should be taxed more. So actually, it's very difficult to justify or say whether it's right or wrong. But as a consumer, anybody, bulk consumer, generally pays less. It is so in railway traffic, it is so in other tariffs. But in water tariff also, they have planned in such a way, there are telescopic traffic. So you consume more and more water, you start paying less and less. And then there is 100% metering. He told that initially there was resistance to metering, then slowly and gradually people realized that they will have to pay only for the actual use, then they everybody installed the meters, and they were AMR meters. He also claimed that AMR meters were used first in India. What are AMR meters? AMR meters are automatic meter reading. Now, what is automatic meter reading? Very, very interesting concept. Let me read out first. What is AMR? AMR is technology of automatically collecting consumption, diagnostic and status data from water meter or energy meter device. It may be gas, it may be electricity, it may be water supply, and transferring that data to a central database for billing purpose, troubleshooting purpose, and analysis purpose. This technology mainly saves the utility
providers the expense of periodic trips to each and every point. Then another advantage is that the billing can be based on the near and real-time consumption rather than on estimates or predicted consumptions. A timely information with analysis can help utility provider and customers the better control of the use and production of energy, gas or whatever it is. The AMR technology, most importantly, also includes handheld devices, what you saw, mobile devices. If anybody was alert, he would have seen a mobile in addition. Then network technologies, mobile technologies, and telephonic platforms also. Now it is wired as well as wireless technology. Also radio frequency, he was talking about radio frequency. So now a person just passes by a household, just clicks few buttons and knows what is the meter consumption. One Nagar Panchayat is using this advanced technology. Customer is satisfied, provider is satisfied, what else we require. Now, we check them also. This is small video shows about electric vision. I don't know whether it comes out correctly or not. Let me see. Maybe in this computer, it's not compatible with computer, but this basically shows how electrofusion technology works. In a heating element on both sides, pipes are inserted, a small current is applied so that pipes are softened, they are tightened, and the smooth joint is created. And the same technology also used for giving connection, not only joining the pipes, because these pipes come in 100 meter length, HDP pipes. So every 100 meter you have to make a joint. What are advantages of this system? Saving of energy, because you don't waste energy in unnecessary lifting of water. People don't store unnecessary water, there is no unnecessary water storage, so lot of saving of energy. Reduction in operation cost, because water losses come down to 5% from 550 to 60%. And the utility gets enhanced water tax revenue. Before project, utility was collecting only 17 lakh rupees per annum, and now after this project, they are collecting 60 lakh rupees per annum.
You know, law mentioned 5% reduced. 5%
in the
form of leakage of pipe?
Leakage of pipe.
On the mouth of open...
Only pipe, not open tap. Once it is built, it is at end of consumer. If consumer wants to allow water to flow, it is loss of water. But consumer is paying. But once the consumer is very confident that he will get next bucket of water, he will not waste.
It will reduce contamination.
Yeah, both. Basically, water loss. Since you don't have to supply more water. This is also a reduction of the water loss. If there is 5% is similar water loss and you are producing 100 MLD instead of 200 MLD, your gross in any case comes down. So in absolute terms, also in relative terms. 70% of the residents have less than 70 rupees per monthly water bill. Water is safe, no chances of contamination. Why no contamination? Because HDPE pipe, yes. No joints are very secure, no chances of waterborne diseases, diarrhea, jaundice, cholera, dysentery, etc.
Pressure is there, so it is very
easy to understand, because all of them are senior engineers, they understand. The pressure is there, so nobody can enter in the pressurized atmosphere. And this best part of this water supply scheme is that it is easily replicable. Nothing is there which is site-specific or cannot be done anywhere else. So I fail to understand why it is not being replicated. It is for small, in our state also, there is very, very small areas in which we are planning water supply schemes. This scheme components are very, very easy, not a very high cost intensive. They can be easily duplicated, replicated. And if somebody wants, I can give a copy of this presentation again, because I have an idea that mind sees, eye sees only what mind knows. So if we run this film again, then you will find this, okay, this is the meter which we are talking about, this is the technology, this is radio frequency, and look, here is mobile. If you were careful enough, you will see that in SMS he was sending from mobile collection, open pump 2, and pump was started. This is beautiful technology, which seeing is believing. Once you see that technology, then if anybody wants, number of copies of this film can be made. This is a government film, absolutely no problem about distribution and sharing it, and this is intended to be shared with everyone who wants it.
Their supply is more than the demand.
Sure.
That's why it is possible. Here it is not.
No, it is only for those areas where distribution is a problem, where other procedures like maintenance of proper pressure, timely supply, because here they are using water gem software. Now water gem software is actually a software which optimizes the pressure and requirement, and also the timely variation of people. People require water more in the morning hours, less in the evening hours. And there is time when no water is required. So at that time, pressure is not required. So that software actually manages in such a way that water is available and at right pressure at the right time, which is very difficult. We generally have our experience. We have experienced pumping, you know, in morning time they have to pump
one time.
Timing is very important. Then again, if you pump unnecessarily, your energy is wasted. So right amount of pumping at right time. Those things are required. So in our areas, in those areas where there is a small area, a standalone kind of scheme can be done, and this can be replicated also. We Calcutta yesterday, I told you, in a very advantageous position, we have a lot of water supply. We need not worry. In Calcutta town, but in added areas, wherever there is new population coming up, and yesterday we saw that rural population is changing into urban population at very, very fast rate. Very, very fast rate. In West Bengal also, there are places where we can face this kind of problem if we don't plan properly, like Bankura district, like Purulia district, where there are rivers are there for getting to drinking water supply needs, but to draw that river water, make it potable, then supply, and at optimum pressure so that residents get the 24/7 water supply is the ideal thing. I would strongly advise this, if anybody is interested in seeing this operation of this scheme, to go to that place. Satara is not so far. It is worthwhile. It is worthwhile going there, seeing this in operation and replicating it our own place. And as you saw, they were themselves talking of making another project of this kind. Same way. Now coming to another part. This scheme, namely water supply scheme. Sure.
I have a question.
It's on no profit, no loss basis. Whatever is the operation maintenance cost, that when you are operating a system on no profit, no loss basis,
the government, the government, I do have 15 family members. He has got 200 family members. The rate will be the same.
No, it's not same. It is on the basis of actual consumption.
Actual consumption.
Yes. I will give you a copy of this presentation. Actually, what happens is you see it again and again. Each and every frame is educative. I told you, I will see only white wine nose. Now you know that there is actual consumption. Now you see and find out in which frame and how he is talking, that people are paying, they are paying 100% because they know that they have been charged only for amount which they have actually used, not on presumptive basis, not on basis of slab, not on some. In fact, I did not tell, but he was talking that the scheme is pro-poor. It's very difficult to justify that how the scheme is pro-poor. He justifies that the scheme is pro-poor because poor people don't have to pay more. It so happens in all of our, those who are followers of economy, they know it very well, that ultimately poor people end up paying more for everything. Everything. Very good that you agree with me. Rich people get everything free. There is concept of economy. and poor people ultimately pay for rich people. So anything which benefits poor people benefits large amount of persons. This is a concept of economy. Great economists say this. I also believe in the great economist sayings. So there it is. But I would strongly advise to take away as many copies of this film as possible and see again and again. Each and every frame is educative and what concept they are using, how they are ensuring 24/7 water supply scheme. Now coming to another scheme, which is for metro. Luckily in Calcutta, we don't require this kind of scheme. We have potable water. We have very little to worry about the quality of water. We have Ganges water here, which we pump in our storages, distribute it. No kind of such problem. But in South India, there are water wars. You can say there are water wars. Fought in Supreme Court of India, fought in tribunals. In fact, there is a Kaveri tribunal, and there's Supreme Court directions and political guessing over the whether water will be released or not. All those things. Luckily, in this part of country, you don't have any such problem. But when there is problem, you see governments go to all extent to solve the problem. So this particular project, I remember, at that point of time was working in the ministry. This project came in 2008. And with the effort of Tamil Nadu government, as well as central government fully supported this initiative, Tamil Nadu government, they drawn up an ambitious scheme. The ambitious scheme was to use seawater. Seawater for drinking water purposes. It's not costly. Not so costly. That's what we will see. That's what we will see, how village is costly.
The treatment of saline water is much costlier than the normal.
Please see whether it is costly or not. So here this scheme is for Chennai city. And they have found a source of water 35 km down south in Bay of Bengal at a place called Nemeli. This is Nemeli's desalination plant. Nemeli is this name of place. A reverse water osmosis plant at Nemeli, Chennai on the coast of Bay of Bengal that supplies water to the city of Chennai. Here details of this plant. The plant is located 35 km south of city center along the East Coast Road, built at the cost of 871 crore rupees. I remember this cost by heart because earlier it was 533 crores, then budget estimate. When the actual it was sanctioned, it came to cost of 871 crore rupees. So we asked the government of Tamil Nadu to justify the cost escalation. They had sent a detailed note how the cost has increased. Because the project was prepared earlier and this reverse osmosis is a costly thing, etc. Several other things are. I will not go into those details. But I had been following this plan. That scheme which you sanctioned, you have some kind of attachment, whether this scheme is actually coming to an end or not, whether it is meeting its target, whether it is giving water or not, those things were attached. So I kept on following this scheme. This was the second plant in the city after a 100 MLD planted Minjur. There is another place up north of Chennai called Minjur where the first plant was. This is second plant. This is an overview of the plant. You can see on one side and on side of sea this plant is located. Yes. Yeah. This plant has capacity to treat 100 MLD of water, sea water, out of 265. That means this draws 265 MLD and ultimately you get 100 MLD. The plant was commissioned, actually started on 22nd February 2013, this year, inaugurated by this year only. So 2009 to 2013, it was actually sanctioned in 2009, sometime around March or April. That time I was in this ministry, therefore I knew this thing. And it took 4 years, about 3.5 years to. Inaugurations are, time-bound manners. But this is basically pipe water supply scheme for resident of South Chennai and newly merged area of Chennai. This plant is owned by Chennai Metro Water and Sanitation Board. Like we have TMWSA here, they are also having CMWSA there. It was constructed by BA Technology. Those are detailed things. And L&T made a 65 km long pipeline from the plant to various parts of city and built interlocked some centers. This is a picture showing pipeline. How it is going around and water is being drawn from this. The plant was constructed with a grant obtained from central government, which I told. The underground sumption water distribution stations were located at Thiru Vanmani Yar, Velachiri, Nemelli, Kilambakkam, and Akkarai. Pumping stations at other places, and the combined capacity was 1375 horsepower. The process technology involves marine seawater intake system, pre-treatment system consisting of disc filters for away ultrafiltration. There reverse osmosis technology. 1050 meter long pipeline with a diameter of 1600 millimeter HDP. This is actually kilometer, not meter. This kilometer. Ultimately, sunk at depth of 14 meter in the sea side. Now 14 meter in the sea side, so that now here we are using HDP pipe again to send the pressure of the, and they are drawing so that the pipe can withstand the pressure. And on shore side it is 5.5 meter. Inside sea side it is 14 meter and shore side it is 5 meter. Intake pipeline. Capable of drawing nearly 265 MLD of seawater by means of gravity. And thus 750 meter long pipeline with a diameter of 1200 meter, millimeter discharges the wastewater back from plant. So 165, which is wastewater, is again discharged back into sea. So once you draw, then what you treated, you take.
This is the process of?
This process details. Wow. This filtration and ultrafiltration membranes remove the sediment and finer sand particles from the raw sea water imported from Israel. So this membranes are imported, raw sea water is available here. This is photo of the project site. Additional reverse osmosis membranes were imported from Japan. Pipeline varying in diameter from 500 meter to 700 millimeter for distance of 64 kilometer, and bridges were constructed above the pipelines at Kilambakkam, Nuttukadu and Kovalam. 40.5 acre of land were allotted for this plant. 20 acres were required for fewer other treatment units. Plant uses a compact and faster treatment process compared to conventional filtration system used in Minju desalination plant. You don't have any precedent actually. Here, once you are pioneer in a field, you don't have anything else to compare with or to learn any lesson from. The only plant of this kind is existing near Tamil Nadu, near Chennai in Tamil Nadu, is Minju plant. So Minju is the only precedent to follow. Here is a photo of the plant which came next day in the newspapers once it was being inaugurated. The plant treats seawater by means of several ways containing disc filters, ultrafiltration membranes to remove some suspended solids. That is sent for final stage of treatment process. Reverse osmosis membranes before distribution reduce the total dissolved solid in seawater from 40,000 ppm to 300 ppm. 40,000 ppm to 300 ppm, that is huge reduction. The production cost, now it is comparison. The production cost of treated water at the plant has been worked out to rupees 21 per kilometer if you compare from 48 for Minju plant. Now here was the question about the cost effectiveness. If you get a kiloliter of water at 21 rupees, maybe price fluctuation will make it 25 or maybe 30. What the rate will you sell it? How much? Maybe 35, 40, 50 maybe after getting your operational and maintenance cost included, maybe 40, 45. But that is exactly the cost of kiloliter water here, which we are getting free of cost from your Ganges.
Actually, one unit has to be set up.
Yeah.
Taking drying up the water.
Yeah. Once,
desalination plant.
The beauty of plant is the entire cost capital expenditure has been met by the government. This is the beauty. So you don't incur any expenditure in the capital. You incur expenditure only operation and maintenance. Therefore, this cost is low. But if you somebody sets this plant on his own, it can't be 21.
In a conventional water treatment plant, this desalination plant is not included.
Yeah.
There is additional cost involved over and above the conventional. That is why it has to be from here.
But
in the system of operation, that is the RO, that has been reduced drastically.
Correct. But my experience shows that this cost is likely to go up.
It will go up.
Go up. Because this new membranes, it's very difficult to maintain. Because once membranes are replaced, once filters are replaced, you have to get new filters.
which are costly. All these new things, much more costly, and all these new things were built in cost of 871 crore rupees. So this is about the plant. This is how Chennai Corporation is distributing this water to tankers. And here is water for us in front of you. Thank you. No, it's not Chennai Road project. It's a special project.
You are in the mission at that time, no?
I was in mission at that point of time.
Before Dr. Patnaik from Odisha, now Asian director of mission.
Patnaik Mohanty?
Mohanty.
Mohanty, not Patnaik. Mohanty.
Mohanty. Before that you were there.
Mohanty is now Chief Secretary of Hyderabad.
Oh, she said.
Mohanty is Chief Secretary of Hyderabad nowadays, Andhra Pradesh.
Nowadays,
in fact, there are two components of mission. One component relates to, as I told you yesterday, to Housing and Urban Poverty Irrigation Ministry, BSUP and IHSDP. And other component, UIG and IDSSMT, is UD Ministry.
Plant capacity
was for 90,000 persons. This I remember. 90,000 persons, but exactly
MLD.
MLD is the region somewhere. I will find out in later, because now some people are waiting for the time, so I have to finish at 4.
500 MLD.
Like that. It's very, very small as compared to MLD. That's how Chennai Corporation is meeting this demand. Even after this, I can't say that Chennai people are happy and satisfied about the water availability as much as Kolkata people are.
They are carrying water in the wagon, no?
They are carrying water in the wagon. Here we have luxury. Here we have luxury of 24/7 water supply without any technology. We are having water everywhere, absolutely no problem. Old system, it has been innovated during the last 2 decades from Palta. Some additional capacity was also created. But I would say we are lucky. We are just lucky that we are born, brought up, and working in the best of the places.
We are approaching to
saturation level.
We are approaching.
You have to do situation level here on that side.
But imposing with that, or also, it can't be possible. Just
so my person reminded me that my session is. Thank you very much.